Hello guys, this is Srinivas, the developer from the developer channel. Today we are going to solve the Skidmark daily challenge of 21st July 2021. Here this is the problem they have given here. Define class fruit. Today we are going to solve this problem in a Python programming language. So I'm really excited about that. The program must accept the name and quantity of n fruits, and the program must print the total quantity of fruits and total number of fruits. And the program must remove the xth fruit from the list, and then they again list n number of fruits and total count and total value. So this is the code they have already given here. Here they have imported fruit class from the method fruit. So we just need to define that class fruit here. Inside this, they have created used the constructor for declaring name and quantity, and then they have get the value of fruit.count and fruit.total quantity. So we just need to create some class variable for this. And here they have used the delete object, which is nothing but a destructor. We just need to define that. And then here they have printed the object as an object itself. So we just need to override the string function. These are the things that we have to implement in our class fruit. So let's see how we are going to solve that. Like here they have created a class, right? For that I have created a file called fruit.py. F is mar because here the module fruit is mar, and this is a class. So we just need to create this class inside this fruit.py class fruit, and inside this fruit we just need two variables, right? Which is nothing but count and total quantity. Both things are initialized as zero. So I have used, you can do that in separate line like this, count equal to zero, total quantity equal to zero. But Python supports multiple assignment at the same line. So I'm using that. Inside this function, they have created a fruits list, and then they have created an object fruit with the reference of constructor, right? So we just need to create that constructor. Def, that's the syntax for creating a constructor or creating any method, defining a function like using def keyword. And for constructor, we just need to init. So in that init function, first one will separately allocated for the object, which is nothing but self, and the passed two parameters are name and quantity. So we just need to assign a name for that object. For that we just need to use self dot name equal to name, and self dot quantity equal to quantity. After all, we just need to increment the count, right? And the count is a class variable. For to reference that, we just need to use the class name fruit dot count plus equal to 1. So we are incrementing by 1 for each and every fruits. Likewise, we just need to increment the total count, right? Total quantity. For that, fruit dot total quantity plus equal to quantity. So we will increase the count by 1 and increase the quantity by the given quantity for each and every object creation. Likewise, if we do that, it just work fine for the creation part. Up to this, it will work. After that, they have created a delete method fruit x minus 1. By default, Python will handle this delete operation. It will delete the object, but it won't that reflect the count and total quantity. So the count and total quantity will be the same while printing. And here the fruit will be printed as some random object. So it's better to show than speak. So I'm going to do that. Here I'm going to execute the function Python hello.py. Inside this I'm passing four values: four apple, one apple, banana, two, and citrus, which is nothing but a lemon or something, three, dates, four. So we got four fruits, and the total is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 10. So I'm deleting the dates from the list. Dates is in the position of 4. So we got the fruit object, and the count and total value, total quantity are still the same. So we just need to do the decrement operation during the destructor. For that, we just need to define a function called define delete, and this will have the object self or parameter self. So we just need to reduce the quantity, right? Fruit dot count minus equal to 1, and fruit dot total quantity minus equal to the object fruit values quantity, which is nothing but self dot quantity. So if we do that, it will work fine. Hello.py, four values: apple, one apple, banana, two, citrus, three, and dates, four. So we got four fruits and the total quantity of 10. So I'm just reducing or deleting the date here. So now we got three fruits, and the count is 3. The total quantity is 6, which is nothing but the total count reduced by 1 and the total quantity is reduced by 4. So we got that. But here the fruits are not printing as a string values, right? It's just printing as a object values. To modify that, we just need a separate function called def string. So in this function, we just need to return self dot name, which is nothing but a fruit name, plus space, plus self dot quantity. Here this is not Java, it won't can Python doesn't what add string with integer value, it will pass error. To get rid of that, we just need to typecast the value by string, so it will work fine now. But Python ultimately multiplies the string with integer. Like you can do something like character A into 5, it will return 5 A's, but we can't able to add the character with integer. So I'm saying that, and I'm running the program again. Now 4, one apple, banana 2, citrus 3, dates 4. Now we have 4 and the total quantity is 10. This time I'm going to delete the first element, which is nothing but an apple. I don't want an apple. So we got banana, citrus, and dates. The total count is 3 and the total quantity is 9. So it works fine. That's it, guys. That's it for today's video, I guess. Here, this is the format they have given. Instead of space, we just need to specify colon. So space, colon, space. So this is the code for your view. If you implement this class function, it will give you a branch for sure. See you soon with something else tomorrow. Until then, bye.